It started, obviously, I would say everyone laughed at the argument with my mum, really. Obviously, I got to that age where obviously I was 14, just going on to 15. Everyone started to chill out on the streets and that now, and obviously my dad was one of them that you either got something constructive to do or, you know what I mean, forget it, stay at home, do some reading, do some homework. And obviously one of these days it was just come home. I'm a big man now, telling my mum I'm going out, you know what I mean, chill with the lads. No you ain't, I am. So I've gone out the door and then I thought I'm in trouble now, my dad gets home, so I need to do something. And my uncle used to own a gym down the road, Frog Island, obviously the old Robin Hood pub. Obviously it was the old Robin Hood ABC. So I thought if I go down there, I can just tell my dad that I wanted to take up boxing. So I went there and obviously it all came from there really. Yeah, obviously my uncle and my dad, obviously my dad used to box as well. And obviously my uncle was my trainer, he was my manager. So obviously he took me up to where I turned pro as well. So, you know what I mean, a big, big, big side there. Obviously Dave Sticky Pratt, so. I think obviously when I come through, I just wanted to be like Tyson really, that was it. I just wanted to just go there and start fighting, you know what I mean? Obviously that was the way I looked at. I think for me, I used to watch, hear a lot about obviously McKenzie and Pyatt and people like that. And I always used to say, oh, I want to be the next Leicester big name really. But I didn't really start thinking like that really till I was coming to the end of my amateurs really, because like a lot of people didn't want to fight me, you know what I mean? And obviously my trainer John White as well as obviously my uncle used to always say to me, there's a reason, Rendall, why they don't want to fight you. But I was more or less just like a hobby for me really. I just enjoy going to train, I just enjoy going to fight, and that was it really for me. But then obviously in the later ages I started to take it a bit more seriously, and then really things started to shine from there, show how good I really was when I wanted to put my mind to it really. Joel Viney, I think it was, obviously it was one of them where we was in the gym. I think it was about 6-8 weeks training specifically to box. Obviously my trainer at the time, obviously Jason Shinfield, because I'd now changed, was trying to tell me, it ain't all about fighting, Rendall, you can box, you got to box. So I went in there, was working out the boxing side of things, was on it, and everything was looking good. And I always remember I went in the ring, I threw a punch, he threw one back, and I just started throwing windmills everywhere. Throwing windmills, the crowd was going mad, everything. And I think after that fight, obviously I turned around and I read the boxing news, it's like comes out every week, and it said, oh, the debut of Rendall Munroe, not the best, obviously. We think he'll get knocked out in 3 fights. And since then, I always used to say to my trainer, I'm going to prove I'm wrong. And I got my head down and I got on with it, and obviously here I am now. My biggest fight, I'd say them all. Them all, but I think for me, I think I'd say my biggest, obviously, was winning the European from Martinez. Obviously, he was a big name. He'd done this, he'd done that, he'd knocked this out, knocked that out. And I kept telling everyone, you know what I mean? He ain't knocked me out, and he ain't gonna knock me out, I'm gonna win. And I always remember at the bookies, it was about 7-1. And I went to the bookies, I was ringing up all the lads, oh yeah, put money on, because I'm gonna beat him, put money on. And everyone was like, yeah. So I was meant to went to a bookies in Nottingham, because obviously that's where I was fighting. And went in, said to the bookies, oh, what's the odds? And he told us. And I says, I want to put £100 on that Rendall Munroe. And he looked at me and he says, do you know something we don't know? I says, yeah, that's me. He started laughing. He says, I might have someone all then. So yeah, I think another a big fight for me, obviously, Nishioka, even though I lost, big, big learning curve. And for me, it showed that I was good enough to be at that level now. And I learned a lot from it.